now, Scott, you're fairly keen on the team of the century, yeah. Centre-half forward, Wayne.
The team of the century, centre-half forward, is Royce Hart.
Yes, I think Richmond scored one of the coups of the century when they picked up Royce. Rex might be able to confirm this, but they picked him up, but gee, he was expensive. It cost the Richmond Football Club one new suit, six shirts, a pair of shoes, and they lashed out £20 spending money. Rex, can you confirm that with the great centre-half forward?
When I was in Tassie last year at the Tasmanian Football League function, I saw the whole lot. He's still got the whole darn lot there, Sandy, I can tell you now. Now, Royce, they wouldn't listen to you at 22 years of age. You told them you were the greatest ever and they wouldn't listen, son.
I really didn't mean it that way, but it's turned out all right, hasn't it?
It has. Now, apart from you, who do you believe was the greatest centre-half forward?
I think EJ, when he played there at his peak, was a sensational player, and thank heavens he was picked at centre-half back.
Now, the flying doormat was a fair sort of an opponent when we played the Mighty Blues. Apart from that great player, who were some of the players you had difficulty with?
I think he was probably the best because of the fact that early on in his career, Rex, he started off as a defensive player, then added an attacking part to his game with his handball, and I think he stood out above all the rest of them.
And we go to the same hairdresser, so I like your decision. Now, the Mighty Tigers, they had a fantastic era, and what has been described by many in the century as the golden era of the Richmond Football Club under Hafey.
There was no doubt about that. From 67 to 77, played in five grand finals and won four, and had the nucleus of probably the best ever Richmond period.
Not much discussion about the decision of the greatest centre-half forward of all time, Sandy, Royce Hart.
Thank you, Rex. He's a wonderful player.